everyone. My name is K. Venkat Rao, lecturer in physics, Government Polytechnic, Hosur. Today, I discuss about simple harmonic motion and the relationship between the simple harmonic motion with uniform circular motion. First, simple harmonic motion is the motion of a particle whose acceleration is always directed to a fixed point and is directly proportional to a displacement of the particle from that point. Means acceleration of the point and displacement of the particle are opposite to each other in directions. Examples for simple harmonic motion are oscillations of atoms in molecules. Next, uniform circular motion is the motion of a particle which is in circular motion with constant angular velocity. Angular velocity is the ratio of angular separation by time interval. Angular velocity is d theta by dt, or angular velocity omega is theta by t, or theta equal to omega t. Now, the uniform circular motion is compared with simple harmonic motion. For that, consider a particle in uniform circular motion. Name the particle P, and the path of the particle is circle, its origin is O, and circle has so many diameters. We consider two diameters which are in perpendicular to each other. One is x, x dash, and y, y dash. Another is y, y dash. So that the four points on the circle are x, x dash, and y, y dash. Consider the position of the particle P, which is revolving in circular, uniform circular motion. The foot of the particle P on y, y dash diameter is n. So from the origin, y and y dash are in equal distance, and O is the point for the foot of the particle P. Is foot of the particle P is n. The distance between origin O and n is known as the displacement of the particle executing simple harmonic motion. Now, the distance of the particle P is constant from origin, that is denoted by r. Its foot means the foot of the particle P on yy diameter is n. As the particle P revolves around the origin, the foot of the particle P n is denoted by n is oscillating about origin O. Origin O is known as equilibrium point, and y, y dash are extreme points. When the particle P moves from x point to y point in first quadrant, the foot of the particle n moves from origin O to y. Like this, when the particle moves from y to x dash, the particle foot of the particle n moves from y to O. Like this way, when the particle moves from x dash to y dash, the foot of the particle moves from O to x dash. Like this way, the foot of the particle moves from y dash to x, the foot of the particle moves from y dash to O. Like this way, as the revolution completes by the particle P, its foot completes one oscillation along yy diameter. So we consider the projection of the path of the particle P as simple harmonic motion. Now, the projection of the simple harmonic motion on yy diameter is known as simple harmonic motion. That's why I concluded this. Thank you.